Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to another episode here on African Confessions. The following story that you're going to be listening to, it comes from a message that was sent to us by one of our dear sister. The message reads like this. Hello, how are you? Can you please post my own story? Is anonymous. I am in a mess, a really deep mess, and I have found myself in a situation that I cannot control. I am caught up in something that is considered a taboo, something that is so twisted, so much that I can't even talk about it with anyone. That is what pains me a lot. There is no one else to share with my story, so much that I feel really disgusted. I cannot tell my friends about it, and worst of all, I cannot tell my family about it. For I am scared that if I tell anyone, then someone one day is going to blackmail me. The truth is that I am in love with my uncle, my mother's brother. I'll call him Sibo. He's older and married, and I know how wrong this is, but I cannot stop. It started as a simple emotional connection. I was really vulnerable at that time, and he seemed to be the only one who understood me. We began spending more time together, but I never thought that it was going to go this far. It all started when I was going through the worst breakup of my life. I was in a relationship in which I had invested a lot in. My boyfriend, he had been sleeping around and cheating on me, and my self-esteem was shattered. I felt worthless, like I had never been loved or wanted again. Then it happened. We were at a family gathering. I found myself opening up to my uncle. He listened to me like no one else had ever done before. I felt so comfortable around him. We were both tipsy. And when I looked at him, I looked at him with lust in my eyes, and he did the same. It was like we were no longer relatives. He was not my uncle anymore. He became my comfort. Me and him, we spoke. It was so emotional, an emotional charged conversation, not realizing what this was going to lead to. At first, it was innocent. He was very supportive, gentle, and always there when I needed someone to talk to. I started looking forward to seeing him, texting him late at night, and wanting more of his time. But I did not see where this was going. I did not want to say it. One night, after too many drinks at a family braai, we were alone. We talked about life, about love, about everything that had gone wrong in our lives. I don't remember how it all happened, but before I knew it, that was when we crossed the line. It was taboo, the things that we did. We crossed the line that people that are relatives are not supposed to cross that kind of a line. We kissed. It was not just a baby kiss or a peck. It was a passionate kiss, as if we were a married couple. It was wrong. He even said that this is so wrong. I also said the same, but the problem was that as wrong as it felt so damn good. I knew in that moment that we were in a dangerous territory, but it was just too addictive. That night we slept together. I was confused, torn apart, but at the same time, after each and every round, I felt more than good. I had betrayed everything, my family, my morals as a Christian woman, but it was like I could not stop myself. After that night, I promised myself that it will never happen again. But I visited him at his workplace after hours. Then we did it again in his car. We could not stop. Whenever we had family gatherings, we would sneak away to be together. And we have been doing this for years now, until I fell pregnant. I fell pregnant. It was a mistake. I really do not know what happened, because I have been taking my family plan, but it just happened. And I carried this pregnancy in secret, pretending that it belonged to someone else. This is my secret between him and I, always hidden from everyone else. The wife does not know anything, and that only fuels my resentment towards her. That is the problem now, because now that I have a child for my uncle, I cannot stand her. It is like I hate that she gets to be with him 24/7, live with him when I also want to be with him and have the life that I want. I have even thought about getting rid of her. I know that it is evil, but this thought has been in my mind more often than I'd like to admit. I want to confess that on Facebook countless times I have seen traditional healers that claim that they are very powerful, that are from a neighboring country, you know who, the Americans. I have been thinking of speaking with one, but it is just that I am scared of maybe getting scammed or maybe ending up with a dogology or something that I won't be able to control. I have been reading some posts about those people who claim that they can do something that can make a man to be yours forever. In our area, I know a Shangoma. So this Shangoma, I have since spoken with her about some small issues. So I have told her that there is a man whom I am in love with, but I want the wife to be gone, to make her sick, drive her away, or worse. She must just leave anything, everything, so that I can move in. I know that the things that I have been doing, it is something that is taboo, and I cannot be with my uncle because no one will approve of that relationship. To me now, it is too strong. It's like an obsession. Have you ever been obsessed about something? That is all that I think about day and night. That is all that I think about. Every time that I get close to making that decision, something holds me back. Like maybe this is the last shred of my conscience as a Christian woman telling me that the things that I want to do, it is very, very wrong. I do fantasize sometimes of causing her to have an accident. She is working as a paramedic. I just pretend as if one night they get called somewhere to go and pick up a patient as she is racing with the ambulance. Then she just has a head-on collision and she dies on the spot. And this will help me not to bewitch her, but to move in with my uncle. Is this even normal? The longer that this thing is going on, the more that I get so obsessed. I am in love with him. I love him in a way that scares me. I know what we are doing is wrong. I know that if my mom will find out, I'll be breaking her heart. Just imagine that I had a child with my uncle. What will people that know me say about me? Won't even we be on the news if this thing comes out? It just started as a small fantasy, but now he also tells me that he wants us to be together, even to move to a different province so that we can raise our family there, where people do not know us. Dear listeners, right there was a message that was sent to me by one of our admin who received this message. Strange things indeed they do happen in this world. Yo. Yeah, nee.